Welcome everyone to this tutorial. In this tutorial I'm gonna show you guys how to change the game music in Train Simulator. In this particular case it's 2016. But let's go straight to it and I'm gonna show you how to do it. Anyway, we're back in the folder. I've got two windows open. One is the all the stuff that I need to change it over to use it in the game. So what I'm going to do now, guys, is I'm going to the RealWorks folder. Normally you can find it in Steam apps, Common, and on RealWorks. You're going to add sets, then I KU. No, I said that wrong. But anyway, open that map, open the core map and the audio map. So in that map, there are all the files that you hear in the game as default. It's not the locos or trains, just only the default game. And also the music of the game. And that's particular is the front end loop. I also replaced that one from Matt, and I also make there a backup of. And I also make a backup from the old one, the original that comes with 2016. Anyway, and also, I cannot say it enough, make a backup. Then you're gonna look it for this file over here, and you're gonna open that, in my particular case with Notepad++. When you open it, you're gonna search for this particular region. It's between 144 and 160. In that particular case, you have the basic volume of the game music. By default, it's on 0.2. You can raise it up a little bit, but it's not really necessary, but it's possible. Don't make it too quick and getting too high, because if you set it too high, it's gonna be really loud. So don't mess with it if it's not necessary. What you're gonna look for is this particular one. And that's, as I mentioned before, the name of the original based audio. We're gonna change that one to the newer ones we are gonna use. So let's go to the audio map. And what I'm gonna do is just copy the complete name. Instead of the typing over, you can type it manually, but I more recommend it to copy the complete name and you make sure that it's gonna work. After that, just place it and place it there in that one. And if you've done that, just click on the save and it now save on the file. Now you save it, just fire up the game and you'll see what it's going to do. And we're back in the game. And as you can hear, guys, it's working perfect. So, I hope this tutorial is working for you as well. So if you have some questions, please let me know in the comments below or on the Steam group as well. So, with that, thank you everyone for watching and I hope to see you next time in another tutorial or on the live stream. So, yeah, thanks for watching everyone. See you next time. Bye bye.